Hi, this is Bob Swanson, astronomy instructor for ICC, and we're going to get into the lab activity for Module 10. And obviously, you click on the modules and go to Module 10, and you're going to see the Module 10 lab activity. Again, there's a link to the student guide. There's a link to the lab quiz. Before you try the lab quiz, make sure to go through the student guide and particularly go through the activity. So you click on this particular link, and it'll take you to the main page for the atmospheric retention lab. This one has a number of background pages and then a couple of simulators that you'll use to complete your lab quiz. But again, can't stress enough the importance of going through the background material. This video is going to focus mostly on the background material, and I'll do a separate video to talk about the simulators. So when you click on escape velocity, this lab deals a lot with escape velocity. And the first thing you need to understand when we're talking about escape velocity is the fact that air has mass. And you can figure that out just by waving your hand in front of yourself. You know, there's air in your room. Wherever you're seated right now, there is air in that room. We can't see it, but we can certainly feel it. When you wave your hand in front of yourself really quickly, your nerve endings tell you that you're hitting something. So it's very clear that the air has mass. Another thing that we know about air in your room is that it has a particular temperature. And it has temperature. When we say temperature, what we're really talking about is the average kinetic energy of the air molecules in your room. And kinetic energy, if you've studied anything about physics or physical science, kinetic energy is energy of motion. So these air molecules that are in your room right now are moving around. And the average kinetic energy is what we call the air temperature. And it turns out the kinetic energy depends upon both the mass of your air molecule and the velocity. And so the faster air is moving around, the greater the average kinetic energy, and therefore the greater the temperature. When the air molecules aren't moving around as fast, then there's less kinetic energy, and therefore the average kinetic energy is lower, therefore a lower temperature in your room. But that's all when we're talking about temperature, we're really talking about air molecules moving. Now on this background page, one thing we also need to understand from Newton's first law is that objects moving in a straight line should continue to move in a straight line forever and ever and ever. And so air molecules that are zipping around, they should just zip in a straight line out into space, if it weren't for the fact that there's a force that keeps the air close to the Earth, which is gravity. Just like the moon would go off in a straight line if it weren't for the force of the Earth's pull, what we call gravity, keeping the moon in orbit around the Earth, and likewise the Earth around the Sun. You know, all objects should move off in a straight line in space unless it's being acted upon by an outside force, such as gravity. So therefore, this whole background page on escape velocity really talks about this, the fact that air is bound to the Earth, but not bound in equal ways. It depends upon the mass of the object. So it turns out that less massive gases, such as hydrogen and helium, have a lower escape velocity. If they achieve a certain velocity, they can actually escape. The Earth's gravity is not strong enough to hold on to those particular gases. And so you can actually calculate an escape velocity. And there's another, the next page is about projectile simulation, where you can figure out what is the minimum velocity that something would have in order to escape the Earth. And so you fire this thing at different velocities and see whether your projectile escapes. But it's a very similar thing to the gases in our atmosphere. Certain gases have enough velocity that it is greater than the escape speed, and therefore they're able to essentially leave the atmosphere, go off into space. Other gases that are more massive don't ever achieve enough escape velocity to escape the Earth's atmosphere. So it turns out that it has a lot to do with the mass of the gas and its temperature. Because as this speed distribution shows you, this is actually a collection of gases. And when I click start, notice that when we talk about the average kinetic energy, it's much like the average grade of your class. You know, we could say the average grade is 79%. Does everyone get a 79%? No. Some people are higher achievers, some people are slackers. But on average, the average is 79. Well, same thing with any collection of gas molecules. Even if they're the same gas, if it's helium, if we had a whole collection of helium here, we could say on average the temperature is 79 degrees, meaning that the average kinetic energy would be equivalent to 79 degrees, but you're going to have some helium molecules that are slackers and are moving slower. Other helium molecules that are higher achievers and are moving faster, but on average you have this peak right here. And so this little slider allows you to show, you know, when I go down here to the slower speeds, well, yeah, most of my particles are moving at or a lot faster than that particular speed. Here, when I'm kind of in the middle, that shows that half the molecules are moving faster than that speed, and half the molecules are moving slower than that speed. So that's your average. Here, these are your high achievers, right? There's not that many of them, but they're going much faster than the rest of them. If I switch colors and show this end of the spectrum, here, these are your slackers. There's not that many of them, but they are indeed going slower than most of the others. Okay, so that essentially shows you the Maxwell distribution and kind of explains why it's important. It turns out that the average velocity depends upon the temperature as well as the mass. The larger the mass, the lower the velocity for a given temperature. For a given mass, the higher the temperature, the higher the velocity, the higher average velocity. Okay, so this kind of gives you a run-through of the background material. Again, make sure you read these, make sure you play around with these little distributions. Some of them you'll be using the background, the escape velocity page for number one on your lab quiz. You'll be using the background page two about the projectile simulation for the number two on your lab quiz. So make sure you go through this. You also use the escape velocity for another question on the lab quiz. So these are useful, they're valuable, they will help you in getting through your lab quiz and getting a good grade.